Hooper, shoot him.
Oh my God, that was bad. That was bad. That was good.
Yo, welcome back to another one, guys. I hope you guys are enjoying these laws and regulations videos. Now guys, just so you guys understand what I'm doing with these, originally I just thought of doing these series of videos in relation to, you know, the ultimate reminders that you needed, the most important reminders right before the fowl season, before dove season, all this stuff. Just some of them really important reminders to give you guys. A lot of you have been like, hey, you didn't cover this part of lead shot. Hey, you didn't cover this part of, you know, limits on doves. So I did four of these videos. Now I'm going to get a little more intricate with some of the questions that you guys have asked in the comments. And we're going to attack some of those intricate questions. Today is going to be, why is lead illegal? So we're going to cover that, kind of bash it to death, and then, you know, whatever comments or questions that you guys have about these four videos that I've done on limits, you know, till limits, all that stuff, drop them down below, and I will be sure to cover the ones that I think are really intriguing and need to be covered. So, again today, I got my trusty little paper so I don't get mixed up and kind of guide me along the way. Don't mind my glasses, my old man glasses are still tinted from being out in the sun. But here we go. Most of you probably know why lead shot is banned. It was banned back in 1991 due to the fact that it's toxic and becomes toxic to animals. Now, let's get into the intricates of what makes it toxic and how it affects the animals directly. So now I'm just gonna read from the paper. It's just got a lot of good facts from it that came directly off of the internet, so let's just start at the top. It was banned back in 1991, 24 years after non-toxic shot requirements were established for waterfowl. Attention has now shifted towards lead poisoning in other species. Those species being upland game birds, scavengers such as vultures, hawks, eagles, and other water birds that are exposed to lead through the ingesting of spent lead shot, bullet fragments, and fishing sinkers. So guys, the bird species scavengers are eating other birds with lead shot in them. So the birds that they're eating were shot with lead shot, you know, upland game birds being now damn sure not waterfowl because it's been banned for 24 years, but they're eating, you know, quail, dove, these birds that have lead shot in them. So when they eat it, they ingest it, they get poisoned, blah blah blah. Also, the ingestion of bullet fragments in the water or in birds or in game, in deer, you know, if a vulture is eating a deer and eats that lead shot, that's what they are referring to. And fishing sinkers, how many of you out there use freaking lead fishing sinkers? I know. But yet again, it states that the most significant hazard to wildlife is through the ingestion of the lead shot through wounded or dead prey. That being said, how many species of wildlife out there do we still use lead shot on? I want you guys to drop your comments down below. Let me know if you agree with this, if you disagree with this. I know that this is a pretty broad, could be argument, but it's a broad point to a lot of us hunters that still, you know, use lead shot for upland game. So drop your comments down below. Let me know what you think about this. So if this is a big problem with the upland species, just think if they hadn't have put an end to this, you know, in the last 24 years, if they would have still allowed lead over water and all that lead shot sitting in the water, this is what that amounts to. Another eerie part is that the lead dissolves and enters groundwater, which in turn could be very hazardous to people. So croplands, you know, irrigation units, spraying it on crops, and that crop actually growing with high content of lead in it. These are things that if 24 years ago they didn't stop it with waterfowl, it would now be a lot worse. Think about how many of you out there, how many of us out there waterfowlers shoot over water, you know, shoot ducks and geese over water. So if you could imagine all that lead being left in the water and it dissolving, running off, getting down into the groundwater, and yeah, it could be a real mess, guys. Another thing is, when you guys go hunting quail, pheasant, anything like that, be sure to look at your, you know, your breasts, not your own breasts, but the dove, the quail, the pheasant, all those, look at the breasts, look at the meat, see if there's any sign of infection. If there is, kind of inspect that. You know, a lot of times if a bird is shot with lead and it's not dead, it will get infected, and the area will be infected in the muscle that it has infected. So guys, there is just a ton of bad things about lead. You know, it used to be in paint, gas, all this stuff, and lead has been pulled from the, you know, any factors that could relate and something bad happening to us. You know, getting in the water is our biggest worry. If lead contaminates our drinking water or our crop irrigation wells enough, it could be a very, very bad deal. So in two regards, this was the most asked question over the last four, you know, the series of four videos, is why is lead shot, Bobby, why is lead shot actually illegal? This is why, guys, because it is very poisonous and pollutant to the environment. Now, guys, I know there are some other factors about why lead is illegal to use and everything, especially for waterfowl. If you guys want to drop those comments down below and let us all know, I always reply to every one of your guys' comments. Let me know. But it is the main reason why lead shot is not allowed for waterfowl. So I hope I answered a lot of your guys' questions accurately. Let me know if I didn't. Go ahead and follow me on Instagram right here. I'd greatly appreciate that. Always try to keep it populated with news and updates, you know, all the duck stuff. Oh, and by the way, the ducks are the Ducks Waterfowl Company. We are coming, we have came a long ways actually in the last week with you pro staffers. We got a lot of you folks picked out. I am actually headed to Flares this weekend. We are going to get down and release a bunch of stuff for you guys. So be expecting all kinds of stuff coming your way via ducks. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoy all of it that we have coming towards you, because we are so excited to release it. Remember, if you guys have any questions concerning these laws and regulations videos that I've been covering, drop them down below. I have about three or four of them that are still gonna be coming your guys' way this week into next week, so be expecting those. I wanna thank you guys for watching, and come on back, subscribe if you haven't, because this waterfowl season is gonna be the biggest, the best here on YouTube. We're gonna blow it up. I can't wait to show you all guys what we have coming. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you yet again. Peace. Guala, 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 guala. I'm living like it's no tomorrow. Don't know my style, won't let you borrow. You're thirsty, have a glass of water. I'm killing these beasts, I'll be more dead. I'll put my